except raindrops from the clouds, sunlight up the sky, oh, and hummingbirds do fly. Oh, say that the raindrops keep on falling, teardrops are falling from my eyes. Sunlight up the sky, oh, and hummingbirds do
Street life, gonna feel the cold. Nothing's wrong for sale. A grown-up fairy tale. And you'll always find beneath the silver spoon. When you keep it young, a song will always sung. Every night you play, the changes who you are. Thank you.
University of Shreveport enrolling now. Call this number or go to susla.edu today.
Thank you. honorable members of the Southern University Board of Supervisors, System President Belton, distinguished platform guests, colleagues, faculty, staff, students, family members, friends, supporters, and most importantly, graduates, good evening. You may be seated. As the Chancellor of Southern University at Shreveport, I am honored to announce and declare that the 2019-2020 and 2020-2021 academic years are now closed, and the spring 2021 commencement exercises are now in order. And one of the things we really wanted to do as we celebrate this year's graduates to make sure that we had an opportunity to celebrate last year's graduates who did not have an opportunity to participate in a face-to-face commencement exercise. So graduation is a joyous, proud, and exciting time. Let me be the first to say how proud I am of these graduating classes. They exemplify the academic quality of all SUSLA students and give credence to the comprehensive preparation that will allow them to be distinguished amongst the global marketplace. This year, we are proud to have prepared 521 graduates to take their rightful place in our competitive society. Please rise and remain standing for the invocation by Brian Wilson, pastor of Galilee Missionary Baptist Church, and you may be seated for the duration of the program this evening after the invocation.
Please bow your heads in a word of prayer. O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is your name in all of the earth. We thank you for this day, for this is the day that you've made, and we are glad in it. We thank you for the graduates. We thank you for this culmination of their hard work, that you're allowing them today to experience the fruits of their labor. Pray, oh God, today that, Lord, as they end this chapter, that you would be with them as they begin the new chapter. Pray, oh God, Lord, that you would touch the families and touch them in their pursuits of their future. And God, we pray for this institution, that you will continue to bless it and continue to allow it to prosper. It's in your name that we pray, and we all say it together, amen.
So much to thank God for. So many wonderful blessings and so you pray. starting me on my way, for letting me see the sunshine of a brand new day, a brand new mercy along with each new day. That's why I praise you.
good evening. Congratulations, graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct honor to introduce this evening's commencement speaker. Afrika Duhaney West joined Ochsner LSU Health in March 2020 as Chief Operating Officer and was promoted to Chief Executive Officer in December 2020. She began her career in healthcare as a nursing assistant in 1990. She went on to become an RN working in medical, surgical, behavioral health, and critical care. As a certified safety professional, she has become a champion of quality and patient safety. Afrika Duhaney West has built a strong reputation as a passionate and dynamic servant leader with over 10 years in executive leadership experience. West holds a bachelor's degree in nursing, a master's degree in nursing science, and a master's degree in business administration. She serves on numerous civic, industry-based, and local boards and organizations. She and her husband, Jay, are the proud parents of 5 children and 5 grandchildren. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Afrika Duhaney West.
Thank you. Congratulations, SUSLA graduates. It is your time. You have proven as graduates of one of the most prestigious HBCUs in the country, you're equipped to take on the world. You have pushed through attending classes online and not by choice, a national pandemic that changed the lives of us all, losing family members and friends who are unable to be here today. You persevered. It is your time. It's an honor and a privilege to stand before Chancellor Dr. Rodney Ellis, faculty, staff, alumni, and most of all, our future leaders, you. Will you be prepared for your moment? This generation has been given many labels. Here today, I call you hopeful. Hopeful that what you learn here will prepare you for where you go tomorrow. Hopeful for the skills that have been sown into you will yield your great reward. And hopeful that your missing pieces will come together to complete your masterpiece called life. To the various support systems that cried with you, pulled you through, sat up sleepless nights to pray for you, friends and family who gave financial, spiritual, and emotional support, thank you. Graduates, these are the people who have secured your foundation. I encourage each of you to secure the foundation of the leaders coming behind you. Remember to speak for those who have with no voice. Invite the next person to sit in your seat at the table. And remember, it is not what is said while you're in the room, but who speaks for you when you're uninvited. We all struggle to find our moment, the moment when you realize your why, your purpose, and your passion. Now, many of you will miss all three of these crucial moments in your life simply because you may allow your attitude to hinder your progression, which will stop your growth and cause you to forget your why. I challenge you today, each of you, to get out of your own way, to not allow your past to dictate your future, to take control of your success, which begins today. Today begins your moment. My moment began at age 16. My sister worked at a hospital as a nurse, and I soon became a volunteer. It was Friday. I was waiting for her to take me to the mall to meet my friends. We didn't have Snapchat, DMs, and IGs. That was 30 years ago. She came out of the unit. I approached her angrily. I was mad. There was a cute guy there that I wanted to meet. And my sister proceeded to tell me that she was late for an hour because she held the hand of a patient after her husband left. This was a terminal ill patient. The patient said she was ready to go on. And my sister held her hand until she passed. At that time, I wanted to be a psychologist. I love studying the mind and how people worked. I didn't think I could be a nurse. All the terminologies and the equipment, I didn't think I was smart enough. I couldn't do it. But I was blessed at a young age of 16 to understand that it wasn't about doing an IV standing on my head and all those fancy terminology. It was about a privileged presence to be there with a patient when a husband of 40 years couldn't be there. In that moment, I realized my why. I knew I wanted to care for others and make their lives better. I was always a good student who focused on my grades, but didn't really know where that focus would lead me. Confident I was headed somewhere, just not confident about how I was going to get there. Many days I struggled with my sense of self, but I refused to give up to self-doubt. Yes, some days my why just wasn't good enough. The greatest leaders and biggest success stories struggle with their why being not enough. As you matriculate through life, your why will change. You will lose your why along your journey, but remember your time here at Southern University and the sacrifice you've made. Those sacrifices will always remind you of your journey back to your why. Now, don't underestimate this woman standing before you. I may have lost my why, but God has always known my purpose. I began my healthcare career as a nursing assistant at a nursing home, where I spent my day bathing patients and helping them to and from the restroom. I quickly realized this wasn't my purpose. Simply wanting to help others was not enough. I wanted to make a difference in people's lives. I wanted people to mean more than a medical record and a diagnosis. I wanted them to feel loved, respected, and most of all, encouraged during the most difficult times of their lives. No, I wasn't a doctor. I wasn't a nurse at the time. But to those patients who looked forward to the few moments I shared with them, I became part of their purpose. My why had become my purpose, and finally my purpose led to my passion. I began to work harder, focus more, and plan my what's next. My what next? Certified nursing assistant, yes. I was a CNA, I was a big shot certified CNA. Wrong. The work was the same, and I was still the low man on the totem pole, even with my certification. I gave the best baths, made the beds with a smile, and answered call lights faster than anyone, because I refused to live in my purpose and not do my best while doing so. Now remember what I said in the beginning about some of you may miss all of these phases of your moment. This is the beginning of that transition. When you aren't where you want to be, but refuse to be humble for where you are, you will miss many opportunities. Sit up straight and pull up a chair, Jags. Your moment starts today. After becoming a licensed practical nurse, an LPN, then an RN, a nurse manager, a nursing director, a chief nursing officer, my world began to change. People began to look at me differently. They no longer saw my hard work, but the color of my skin. Doors I used to walk through began to close, and my seat at the table became invitation only. I had chosen healthcare, a profession that was about compassion, empathy, and caring for fellow men. Somewhere along my journey, my success made many forget their purpose. As you move up the ladder in your career, don't allow others' lack of purpose to become your problem. Sometimes when we receive pushback, we tend to stop, stand still, and lose our why, purpose, and passion. If you take nothing away today, graduates, remember this. The key to success is you. And that success begins with learning from your failures. Please know there's no successful person that has not had many failures and is not prepared to fail again. Some of my biggest accomplishments have come from starting over, believing in my dream, and not asking myself why, but when. When I became Chief Operating Officer for LifePoint Health, I knew my next trajectory was CEO. I was offered several opportunities. I turned them down. Why, you ask? For one, in my career spanning almost two decades at that time, I didn't see any CEOs who looked like me. Secondly, the experience of navigating the intersection of race and gender bias day in and out, family, I was exhausted. Having to provide more evidence of competence than my male or white peers, I was discouraged. The expectation that I needed to be more socially accepted and less ethnic resulted in the loss of my authenticity at a time when more than ever, I needed to be proudly anchored in who I am personally and professionally. I lost my purpose, and I questioned my value and worthiness for this very moment. We had a family meeting. My husband, Jay, supportive as always, had really wise things to say. Imani, our youngest of five at the time, she was 13, she said, "Mom, this is not about you. This is bigger than you. Besides, you're already doing it." She was right in so many ways. The day I gave my first patient bath, cleaned my first bedpan, and answered my first patient call light, created a humble foundation preparing me for this very moment. Yes, my experience as a nurse's aide all those years ago was the deepest and most meaningful in my journey. I accepted the CEO position. Today, when people ask to meet the CEO, I keep the same mindset, even if all they see is the color of my skin. I meet their disdain, disappointments, and disbelief with perseverance, passion, purpose, and that's what it looks like standing in your moment, graduates, with faith, humility, and his loving grace. From the aforementioned CEO role, I continue to thrive, each opportunity more challenging and company bigger than the last, spanning three states, bringing me here today to Shreveport, leading as one of the CEO in a billion-dollar company. I stand before you not as blind hope, but a testimony that it can be done. Graduating class, no matter what happens, know that the name-calling, labels, doubts are just temporary distractions. Don't let them define you or hold you back. Use your challenges, disappointments, failures as a catalyst to find your why, develop your purpose, and propel into your moment with passion. Whether you're graduating here today with a certificate or a degree, you are the only one that can write the story you're meant to tell. Go out and make it a masterpiece. Southern University graduates, this is your moment. Thank you.
Yeah, all I can say is wow. That is truly an inspirational story, and we're so grateful to have you as our commencement speaker this evening, delivering a purposeful message to our graduates. And so I'd like to take this time to present you just with a small token of our appreciation, and I'd just like to read it. In appreciation to Mrs. West, keynote speaker, 2020 Spring Commencement, Southern University at Shreveport, Dr. Rodney A. Ellis, May 22nd, 2021. Thank you so much. Dr. Terry Kidd, Vice Chancellor for Academic Affairs and Workforce Development, please present the Chief Student Marshal and the degree candidates.
Thank you, Chancellor Ellis. We have reached a pinnacle moment of this commencement exercise, the awarding of earned degrees, certificates, and diplomas. I am delighted to present the graduate who earned a perfect 4.0 GPA and serves as our Chief Student Marshal for the 2020-2021 graduating class. Ms. Portia Harris, Associate's Degree of General Studies, General Education, 4.0 GPA. Ms. Harris, would you please come forward? Our next student is Charles. Please come forward. Congratulations. Let's give Ms. Harris and Charles another round of applause. This year, we have the distinct pleasure of including the 2019-2020 student marshals who represent the accounting program in the business studies division. Both students earned a perfect 4.0 GPA. Students in our business studies program, including accounting, are included in the procession today. I am pleased to report that for the first time in the business studies history, 54 students have completed their respective programs. The success of this program is the result of the hard work of our students, the faculty, and the support services provided by our Student Affairs Division. Will the staff and the faculty in the accounting and business studies area please stand and be recognized? Thank you, faculty and staff, for your hard work and dedication in working closely with our students. Much better. On the platform with me are the leadership team of the Academic and Workforce Affairs Division. When I call your name, please stand up and be recognized. Dr. Barry Hester, Dean of Business, Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics. Dean Joanne Warren, Dean of Allied Health and the School of Nursing. Dr. Lonnie McCray, Dean of Arts, Humanities, and Social Sciences. Dr. John Galiotos, Dean of Workforce Development. Dr. Veronica McEachin, Associate Vice Chancellor for Academic Innovation. And Ms. Janice Sneed, Associate Vice Chancellor of Academic Affairs and Workforce Development. Thank you, faculty leadership team, for your hard work and dedication to SUSLA. Please be seated. Now for the part that we've all waited for. In the words of Aubrey Graham, also known as Drake, we started from the bottom, and now we're here. Will Dean Joanne Brown Warren and the faculties of the Division of Allied Health and Nursing please stand? Will the candidates for the Associate Degree, Associate of Applied Science, Certificate of Applied Science, Certificate of Technical Studies in Allied Health and Nursing Please stand and come forward.
Shanika Anderson. Taja Atkins. Ashley Brown. Zenobia Laferrin. Shardell Guyden. Yolanda Johnson. Martin Kachacha. Mariana Lovelace. Ashley Morgan. Shakaria Owens. Chantanelle Payne. Keonico Pfeiffer Carter. LaQuanta Quaker. Ursula Scott. Chelsea Smith. Ebony Taylor. Maisha Taylor. Rokita Taylor. Shyla Washington. Allison White. Shayna White. Markel Williams. Stephanie Williams. Karen Woodley. Beatrice Wright.
Thank you, candidates and Dean Warren. Candidates, please be seated. Will Dr. Lonnie McCray and the faculty in the Division of Arts, Humanities, and Social Sciences please stand? Will the candidates for the Associate Degree, Associate of Arts, Associates of General Studies, Associates of Applied Science, Certificate of Technical Study in the Arts, Humanities, and Social Sciences, please stand and come forward.
Madison Brown. Denicia Dunn. Haley Gamble. Shatoya Jackson. Bailey Yeager. Deborah Malott. Kendall Montero. Elizabeth Moran. Victoria Schittner. Brittany Taylor. Khadidra Walter. Brittany Brown. Ravina Buffin. Jakeitha Burrell Lott. Darmiola Bersarian. Marcel Gubadia. Latika Simpson. Camry Thompson. Ebony Harris. Rochesla Johnson. Tamika Roosley. Suzanne White. Tanisha Bullock. Lavarier Burks. Chantel Chitman. Destiny King. Joseph Owens. Rykendrick Simpson. Kelsey Ware. Crystal Welch. Ariel Williams. Elizabeth Dias. Japonica Scott. La Crystalline Fuller. Ashley Dangerfield. Jasmine Wright. Lawana Thomas. Shardae Mitchell. Charlaquin Moore. Selvis Lewis. Selvis Lewis. Florence Quaylen. Bianca Hicks. Rotravius Brown. Hartasha Norwood.
Now, let's try this again. Will Dr. Lonnie McCray and the faculties in the Division of Arts, Humanities, and Social Sciences please stand? Will the candidates for the Associate Degree, Associates of Arts, and Associates of General Studies, Technical Certificate in the Arts, Humanities, Education, and Social Sciences please stand and come forward?
James Johnson. Conceita Hamilton. Jaden Hunter. Montoya McKinney. Jamie Johnson. Victoria Washington. Sherelle Frederick with honor. Roslyn Woodson. Keontae Thomas. Alexis Chanel Wimberly. San Juan Allen Dual Enrollment Booker T. Washington High School. Janice Herks. Ashton Jackson, dual enrollment, Lincoln Preparatory School, Grambling, Louisiana. Austin Jackson, dual enrollment, Lincoln Preparatory School, Grambling, Louisiana. Lisa Jones. Tina Stanford. Tiffany Jordan. Kelsey Key, dual enrollment, Lincoln Preparatory School, Grambling, Louisiana. Philip Parker, dual enrollment, Lincoln Preparatory School, Grambling, Louisiana. Michael Portis, dual enrollment, Lincoln Preparatory School, Grambling, Louisiana. Miranda Smith. Jocelyn Stason, dual enrollment, Booker T. Washington High School. Javian Tatum, dual enrollment, Lincoln Preparatory School, Grambling, Louisiana. Madison West, dual enrollment school, Lincoln Preparatory School, Grambling, Louisiana. Shamaria Wynn, dual enrollment, Booker T. Washington High School. Tiana Barkley. Kayla Armstrong, dual enrollment, Lincoln Preparatory School, Grambling, Louisiana. Jamaria Bryant. Ty Christopher Harris. Shamika Dorsey. Markeisha Jeter. Nana Oka. Trinatica Webb. Quintina Johnson. Cynthia Johnson. Monica Coleman. Taronica Bowles. Prince Hill. Taji Davis. Lakeisha Horton. Tranisha Burns. Shadonald Scott. Brittany Bolden. Lakira Burks. Brittany Haley.
Thank you, candidates. Please be seated. Will Dr. Barry Hester and the faculty in the Division of Business, Engineering, Technology, Mathematics, and Science please stand? Will the candidates for the Associates of Science degree, Associates of General Studies, Certificate of Applied Science, and Diploma of Technical Studies in Business, Mathematics, Sciences, and Technology please stand and come forward? Faculty, please be seated.
Kiata Washington, Business Management. Kiata Washington, Accounting. Jaleesa Brooks Jackson, Accounting. Jaleesa Brooks Jackson, Business Management. Tanaja Coleman. LaShonda Johnson, Business Management. LaShonda Johnson, Accounting. Veronica Marshall, Business Management. Veronica Marshall, Accounting. Kiana Frederick. Remetria Hall. Ricky Hall. Jeffrion Smith. Kimberly Smith. Princeton Sneed. Jerrica Williams. Lee Jeter, Business Management. Lee Jeter, Accounting. Paige Collins. Cortlandria Armstead. Kyra Briscoe. Chastity Alexander. Jada Morrow. Jessica Whalen. Thamesia Kennan. Natia Smith. Mark Matthews. Asia Taylor. Cassandra Williams.
At this time, will all of the candidates please stand and remain standing? Chancellor Ellis, upon the authority vested in me as the Vice Chancellor of Academic Affairs and Workforce, on the recommendation of the faculty of the Divisional Deans of Southern University at Shreveport, it is my distinct pleasure and honor to present the 2019-2020 and 2020-21 graduates for the associate's degrees, certificates, and diplomas to which they are entitled.
Congratulations once again. Upon the recommendation of the faculty, division deans, and the Vice Chancellor for Academic Affairs and Workforce Development of Southern University at Shreveport, and by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Southern University Board of Supervisors and by the President of the Southern University System, I am pleased to confer upon you associate degrees, diplomas, and certificates to which you are entitled, together with all rights and privileges thereto appertaining. Congratulations, you may turn your tassels from right to left. Thank you once again, graduates. You may be seated. And one last round of applause for our graduates.
Shreveport provides adults an opportunity to receive a high school equivalency degree through the High School Equivalency Test, HISET program, which replaced the General Education Development, or GED program. The state has an opportunity and an obligation to work hard to get students into appropriate adult education and training programs and jobs with career paths that give them hope to increase their quality of life and move ahead in the future. These men and women have overcome obstacles to finish what they've started years ago, and tonight we salute them for this accomplishment. Will the faculty and staff in the Department of Adult Education please stand? Will the candidates for the Adult Education Certificate please stand and come forward. Chancellor Ellis, as Associate Vice Chancellor for Academic Affairs and Workforce Development, it is my distinct privilege to confirm 14 graduates for graduation. They have successfully completed the requirements for their 2020 and 2021 HISET diploma.
Gabrielle Latin.
Congratulations.
Thank you, candidate. You may be seated.
Since 1994, the Community Education for Life Transition Program, also known as CELT, has successfully provided educational opportunities for over 100 students with disabilities. As it has been the tradition of Southern University at Shreveport, today, Caddo Parish students who currently participate in the CELT program are recognized. In effect, these students are members of the SUSLA student body and therefore are presented as Southern Knights during this commencement exercise. Thank you, Dr. Ellis, for bestowing this recognition to the CELT students. I ask that you and Rhonda Young please join me in congratulating these students.
As the director of the CELT program, Community Education Life Transition, it is my distinct privilege to confirm two candidates for graduation. The following students have completed all classwork and met all requirements deemed necessary by Caddo Parish School Board. And therefore have earned the certificate of achievement. Candidates, you ready? Christopher Cortez Benjamin. My second candidate for graduation is Nico Charbonnet.
Thank you, Ms. Young, and thank you, Caddo Parish Schools, for your continued partnership. Members of the Southern University at Shreveport class of 2020 and 2021, congratulations once again. You have now earned the right to join the ranks of distinguished alumni. This means that you must commit yourselves to carry on the SUSLA tradition of servant leadership through exemplary careers, service to your communities, and support of your fellow alma mater. Graduates, you are the first class to receive this next honor. Please stand for your induction into the Southern University at Shreveport Alumni Association to be given by Mr. Steve Thomas, the president of the Southern University at Shreveport Alumni Association. And Mrs. Laquita Thomas, president of the Southern University System Federation.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. Southern Knights, are you out there? Graduates, are you out there? All right, let's make some noise in here. Thank you so much, Dr. Ellis, and distinguished guests on the panel. I am Laquita Thomas, the 19th National President for the Southern University Alumni Federation, and I'm delighted to introduce our second president for the Southern University Shreveport SUSLA Alumni Association, Mr. Steve Thomas, and the joke is that there's no relation. We're Thomas and Thomas. So he's going to conduct the oath. So again, graduates, if you would please stand.
I state your name. Am an alumnus of Southern University at Shreveport. Do hereby pledge allegiance to the Southern University. Alumni Federation. And to the great and honored institution for which it represents. I promise to remain loyal, faithful and steadfast in my support of its programs, uplift its principles, maintenance of its traditions, and defense of its honor. I further promise to always stand ready to contribute my time, efforts and finance, assistance and services toward the advancement of the welfare of Southern University Alumni Federation and my beloved alma mater. So help me God. Thank you. You may be seated. Now, this portion is not in the program, but as the Alumni Association president, I'd be remiss if I didn't take this opportunity to recruit for the Alumni Association. So the Alumni Association for membership is a mere $50. $50 a year, and I know a lot of you already have a lot of high-powered jobs already lined up, and you're going out to start achieving, please do not forget about us here back at SUSLA. Some of you may be in some of the recipients of some of those hard-working dollars that came back from the Alumni Association to support you being here today. So again, please do not forget about us, and congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, there are a number of distinguished guests here with us today. Please join me in recognizing them and expressing our appreciation for all they do to ensure the success of Southern University and our community at large. First, I'd like to recognize the dedicated members of our Board of Supervisors. We have with us here today Mr. Sam Gillum, and Mr. Richard Hilliard. Next, we offer special recognition to the president of the university, Southern University System, Dr. Ray Belton, who could not be with us here today. I thank the board and the president for their commitment, counsel, and contribution to ensure the ongoing legacy of Southern University at Shreveport. For every graduate, we know that there is a strong support system. Where would our graduates be without these individuals in their lives? Will the parents, spouses, children, family, and close friends of our graduates please stand and be recognized? We salute you for the sacrifices you have made. Please give them another round of applause. It takes hard work and dedication of the entire campus to graduate a student. With the faculty, staff, and administration of the university and our high schools that have joined us here today, please stand and be recognized. If there are any student leaders in the audience, will you please stand as well? Thank you for all you do to ensure the success of your fellow students. Student leaders. Also, we recognize the presence of our special guests, elected officials, and alumni. I believe I did see Mary Trammell earlier. We have from DC, Mr. Darian Williams. If there are any other elected officials in the audience, please stand and be recognized. Before we conclude, I'd like to take a moment to recognize members of these graduating classes who have served our country. Presented here today, there are a number of individuals with red, white, and blue cords around their necks that also have completed our Veterans Upward Bound program and have graduated here today, matriculating through that program. So please let us recognize our veterans in the audience who are graduating today. Will you please stand? On behalf of the entire university family, let me thank each of you for joining us in this celebration and for the awarding of degrees to the Southern University at Shreveport classes of 2020 and 2021. As we prepare to sing the alma mater, please be seated afterwards for the recessional. We understand how eager you are to see your graduates and embrace them, but we solicit your cooperation in allowing them to complete their recessional with dignity, decorum, on this, their special day. Please stand for the singing of the alma mater.